Humpty Dumpty didn't sit on the wall. He is the wall. Hello, YouTube! This is Chris Maniac, finally done with the Santa's Little Helper series for Christmas. And I'm bringing you another normal battle today. This is my new Volt-turning team. You'll see how it works in battle. And I'm facing the Miles Dario again. And the thing to worry about in this team is that freaking Chansey. Chanseys are unkillable. Like, if you like, even though they only have base 10 defense, I believe, they have bold nature, most of them. Like, they can handle a physical hit pretty well. You'll see in this battle. From my Pokemon hardly do anything to that thing. Anyways, let's start the battle. I believe I lead off with my Flygon just to get a U-turn off and everything. Oh no, no, never mind. My Washington. What's it called? Rotom W. Anyways, in comes his shiny Pinsir, which is really nice. That's obviously his Mega, but because, like, why wouldn't you run a Pinsir in your team? But I stupidly go for a trick here, believing I could just dump a Twist Specs in this thing. But no! Washington, being a boss, just hangs on with his imaginary Focus Sash at 1 HP. And I switch out into my Flygon. He Mega Evolves, and he does a huge number of damage to my Flygon with just a quick attack. Look how much this does. Like, that does like a good... Actually, it's not that good. Actually, no, never mind. For a quick attack, that does a lot of damage. Anyways, in comes Sam I Am, his Chansey, which is shiny too. Your team reeks of insta-check. I say reek because I'm just jealous. I like shinies. I want shinies. Anyways, I bring in Dante, my Mega Houndoom, just so I could think that I could nasty plot my way through this wall. But he has Toxic, so he could easily just outstall me with Toxic. Anyways, he brings out his Mokotanya, his Gyarados, and I Mega Evolve my Houndoom into Mega Houndoom, and I'd like just to say right here that Mega Houndoom just looks so sick. I just love his design, all his bones, like all over its body. It really looks like an underdog, I mean like an underworld dog. And yeah, I go for a Nasty Plot here, I double my special attack, and I Dark Pulse that Gyarados. And that does a lot of damage, and they get a flinch too, so that is great. So, Dante, right on his first battle, he does a really good job. So, yeah, I'm not disappointed at that the damage output. Anyways, in comes Sam I Am, his wall, his unbreakable wall. And that Dark Pulse actually does a lot, considering that's a Chansey with Ivulite, with sky high defense. Anyways, so you go for Nasty Plot here again, just thinking I could do but a bit more damage and possibly do like enough damage to it so that when Dante gets down, this Chansey could be easily revenge killed by one of my Pokemon. So anyways, I go for a second Dark Pulse and it does like a very disappointing amount of damage. That does only like what, 30%? And Dante is at times 4 attack, I believe, and he just gets knocked out by poison. So Dante did a good job this battle, but the wall of a Chansey just outbusts him. Anyways, in comes Brynhildr, my Caesar. Props to you if you get that reference. Anyways, he switches out and they go for the pursuit, thinking it would do a lot of damage, but that only did like five percent to it. It did so little. Anyways, he's staying here on this Espeon, just thinking I could pursue it, but he goes for Reflect. And that, again, that's a very little damage. So I'm thinking, okay, maybe I could switch out into another Pokemon, then we'll switch back into my Caesar, then I could Brick Break his screens away. Anyways, he goes for a Wish again, and I go for another Pursuit just to deal damage to this thing. I guess I don't do that yet. I'm just thinking I could just Pursuit Trap this thing down. Anyways, he withdraws his that Glow though, and I switch into my Rotom. Thinking that he might pass his wish on to his Gyarados. And right here, he told me in Facebook chat, he's like, oh man, you made me waste my wish. Because my Rotom would have easily knocked out his Gyarados from that range, because I could outspeed him and destroy him with a Volt Switch. So Marathon did very good in this battle, even though he had 1 HP and failed to trick that choice specs. He's already 1 HP and allowed that trick not to be passed. Anyways, in comes Blastoise. He's not Mega, but he can still do a lot of work without a Mega Stone, as you'll see later on in this battle. Anyways, in comes his wall. I'm thinking that he would do double switch and back into his Chansey because that thing just walls everything, but his Reflect already wears off, so that break doesn't really matter. And it does a whole lot of damage to this annoying Chansey, about 50%. Anyways, this egg thing throws my Scizor, it doesn't really do much. And in comes Mammoth and Mamoswine, and I'm thinking I can just finish this thing off with the Earthquake. Anyways, he withdraws, and he goes right back into his that Glowthal. It looks really pretty. Shiny Espeon, it's just green. I like its color. Anyways, he just go for Ice Shard, thinking that I can knock out that Chansey. But, I don't. He goes for another Wish, thinking he could pass it onto his Gyarados. And I'm like, oh darn, his Gyarados is going to get a Wish. But why do you put Wish in your Espeon? Don't Espeons get very little HP, like 60 base HP? I would have used Vaporeon for that, for Wish passing. Anyways, he just is out, and I go to my Flygon, just thinking he's going to go into his Gyarados. And he goes into his Chansey, and I'm like, oh, this is perfect. Because Flygon, you can use Super Power! And it finally takes that thing out. It took so much to take that Chansey out. Anyways, that Shiny Chansey is finally out. Not walling my team anymore. And now my team could Volt Switch and U-Turn and all that sort of stuff. That makes it my Volt Switch team. Anyways, in comes my Blastoise. I like how everybody assumes a Blastoise is a defensive Blastoise, but no, my Blastoise has max HP, max special attack, with Aura Sphere, Dark Pulse, Ice Beam, and Rapid Spin. No Water Stab. But yeah, this Blastoise does a lot of work, even without Mega Stone, I mean, even without the ability Mega Launcher. Anyways, my Blastoise knocks out that Gyarados with a Dark Pulse. In comes his Espeon, thinking he can set up a Light Screen, and maybe survive one hit from my Blastoise. But no, Gunther is Turtle with cannons in his back, and it's just gonna blast you away with the Dark Pulse, with his Dark Thoughts. Down goes the Espeon, and my Blastoise is just going on a roll right now, just destroying everything on Dimal's Dario's team. And in comes his Oog Helium, which is his Mega Pinsir. And did you see how much that Quick Attack did? Wait, that was a Quick Attack, right? Oh no, that was our turn. But I did so much to my Blastoise, damn. I got Earthquake by a Flygon recently, and I did only like 30% to my Blastoise, even though it has no defense investment. But wow, Pinsir hits like a truck! That thing is a real threat. Anyways, in comes my Flygon, and I'm, what's it called, Scarf? He doesn't know that, so I could just knock this thing out with a Stone Edge. And thankfully a Stone Edge hit, because without that Stone Edge hit, I would have been in a big trouble without that. Anyways, in comes his, what's it called, Azumarill, which is shiny too. Damn, so much shiny is in this guy's team. Knocks out my thing with Aqua Gen. And then I sent in my Mamoswine. And I don't know why he switched out here, because now he just Earthquake something. And that turns out to be his Garchomp, which is awesome. I get a lot of damage off in this thing. And right here, I know I could take another Earthquake from this Garchomp because this Earthquake does only like 50%, so I go for our Reflect. And that basically secures my victory because he only has his Azumarill left, I believe, and his Garchomp. And his Azumarill is obviously a physical attacker, and that wouldn't do much to my Pokemon that are left, which is my Scizor and my Mamoswine. Anyways, in comes his Azumarill again, just to Aqua Jet Mamoswine down, and then goes Mammoth, doing a good job of setting up a Reflect and taking out the Garchomp. So in comes Brynhildr, my Scizor, knock out that Azumarill with a bullet punch. Oh, wait, no, yeah. Wow, Azumarill is so bulky because like my Scizor is like Choice Banded and that stab and stuff with Technician. Anyways, good game, Dimal's Dario. you'll see many more games versus this guy, because me and this guy have many good games, and they're extremely close. Anyways, that's my Volturn team. Hope you guys enjoyed the battle. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you did, and I'll see you all next time!